I have a question. You brought something up in October IA. I thought that infinity implied infinite possibility.
Infinite possibilities are there, but only in the earth you can become enlightened. That is why the earth is unique.
But if the universe is infinite,
it is infinite, you can realize that only here. Even the devatas, gods, rishis, siddhas have to assume this body in this earth to become enlightened.
Thank you.
The way it is.
I have one more question. Is it very important that I get a spiritual name?
It'll really quicken your enlightenment process. As many number of times your name has been remembered by you and others, that many number of times it will be quickened with a spiritual name.
Well,
because it literally from inside makes you as a new person.
Well, can I do it by without? Can I buy it so that I don't have to go through the bureaucracy?
I stopped giving. Even in the website, I stopped giving. If you want to legally change, ask. Otherwise, don't ask.
Okay. Thank you.
Swamiji.
Backside.
Zit side. Swamiji.
Yes.
I would like to ask a question about how we should treat our human ashes after we die and are cremated. You see, we are Chinese Asian from Singapore, Malaysia and Hong Kong. And we do not have the practice of scattering our ancestors' ashes over Ganga River. Our tradition in our country has been to keep all our ancestors' ashes into urns and put the urns in temples for our children and descendants to pay respect to. And some of us turn this into diamonds. What I would like to ask you is, because we do not have Ganga River and we Chinese Asians, how should we advise our descendants and children to treat our ashes?
No.
Does it affect our enlightenment?
No. If you ask me, naturally I can give opinion only based on my experience and the experience of the rishis, ancient masters. So based on that, the opinion is drop it in the Ganga. Drop, sprinkle it means put it in Ganga. That's a best thing. After that, anything you want to do as per your tradition, up to you. I cannot comment on it. Yes.
Thank you.
Swamiji. Backside. I would like to request blessings for the Gurukul.
Tathastu. Then.
Thank you. And also, I want to have.
You are going to move to Gurukul?
I want to.
What's your age?
10.
Wow, right age to come to me. Come on. Between 7 to 14 is the time Mahadeva is prescribing to be with the master. See, from the birth, you should be with the mother or father till the age of 7. Not just mentally, even physically, means you should be sitting on their lap, playing with them. No question of school till the age of 7. If you want to be dumped by your kids in the old age, you put them in the school before 7. Before 7, no school. They should be just playing in your lap and sleeping in your bed, eating from your plate. It will be great if they are eating directly from your mouth. Means just pulling it out from your mouth and eating. You see, this all brings so much completion to the child. You don't know. See, when you are eating, if the child is just pulling it out from your mouth and eating, never blame the kid. This brings so much completion to the kid. You don't know. That is the best vaccination. That's the best vaccination. You guys are not understanding. Mahadeva very clearly says, the protection your child's body needs when it can't be produced by its own body, the mother's milk and mother's saliva creates that protection. When your child eats from your plate, it reaches the child. Till the age of 7, if your child is playing with you, eating from your plate, all that, as per Mahadeva's order, should be encouraged. Should be encouraged. The child should really be close to you. Then after the age of 7, they should be in the Guru's feet studying. I don't know how many of you will be able to understand what I am saying, but this is what Mahadeva says, and I can stand for it. Yes. The next. Much of you guys lost the completion with that mother in you and father in you because of your stupid distance from your child. Your child is your extension till he or she becomes physically matured. Understand? Till he or she becomes physically matured, he is not given a gender in Vedic tradition. He is only given as your extension. The child, is only an extension of you. The child is not given the gender title till he becomes physically matured. Only after physical maturity, Vedic tradition calls that person as he or she. Till then, it is only an extension of you. That's all. So, it is so unfortunate that parents themselves have lost the completion with their motherhood or fatherhood. Children also continue to carry that deep unfulfillment or incompletion.
Also, I would like to request Samaya Diksha for my cat. As
But you have to bring physically. The cat has to go around the fire pit, that Homa Gunta. Only then I can give Samaya Diksha.
Okay.
I can't give through two-way video conferencing. No, really. Actually, I have to, as per the order of Mahadeva, I have to give Samaya Diksha for any being comes to the place. Whether it is a dog or cat or snake or ghost or Siddha or alien, all beings have to be given. But they have to go around that fire and then come and receive the Diksha.
Then is it possible for liberation for my cat?
Yes. With Samaya Diksha, he will not fall into any more that bodies of ignorance. He can have only one more body, that is a human body, and he will become liberated.
Oh, thank you. And also, am I eligible for Sundarvanam?
I'll give you.
Oh, thank you.
Don't bother about eligibility. I'll give you as my gift.
Swamiji, Deity Sai.
Just get Sundarvanam.
Swamiji, since Mahadeva talks about chocolate, can we have chocolate over here?
He talks about hot chocolate. We can have hot chocolate here, but still we have not, he talks about hot chocolate, but still we have not figured the method of extraction which he describes. That part is not yet translated. We are not able to extract as he wants, but we will provide the hot chocolate as he cooks. See, in the cooking he gives a rule how to make hot chocolate. As per that rule we will make and provide. But the extraction itself, we are not able to still do that. Still we are getting it translated. So as and now, we will make as he says and make it available. Give me
also,
just 2 days time. By the time we will procure everything and make it available.
To make our whole family liberated.
Whole family. Tatast. Blessings.
Thank you. Jiji.
Yes, go ahead.
So Jiji, yesterday, the biomemory completion, I had actually written one of the powers that I was always interested in, was like being able to relate with animals like perfectly. And after that, yesterday we I was first thinking there is trouble over here and all of that. Mm. Then Masnavi gave him some small work. After that, like I went off to the Tiger Kingdom. Mm. And then when I went over there, mm. I was able to see that many of the people were only going to the small tigers, mm. the babies and everything. Mm. But when we entered the cage with the enclosure with like about 8 adult big tigers, mm. and they're all not sedated. Mm. They're jumping in the water, going up and everything. Mm. I could listen to everything that's going on inside them.
Wow.
And like understand every single thing. Mm-hmm. And even when we were sitting, they were telling hold the tail, and they like it. But as soon as I caught one of the tail, that the tiger was like, every stupid human does this, so I would just leave it down. So that is why I was telling my father that why, and they were telling, no, hold the tail and take a photo and everything. So I could literally see, it was not like my assumption or anything. As they were thinking, I could get it. And even being able to relate to them and all, and there's like this no fear or any such thing. And the funny thing was, I thought, okay, it's only up to there. Then we went to see a bunch of elephants right in front. There also, this whole pregnant elephant, I could scan and see it was pregnant. And my dad was also confirming it, saw the whole fetus and saw the movement of that baby inside and all. And when I came back to the hotel, saw this big toad in front of our room, Gigi. And usually I will run very far if I see them or something.
Nanda.
கொஞ்சம் குண்டா இருக்குமே அது So when I saw that, I could see that the toad had seen your image. Mm. Maybe when you were like going in that hotel before, it had caught your glimpse. Mm. So wow. When it came in front of me, I was first standing and seeing how I'll cross that fellow and go. But then I could see that it thought of you.
Wow.
And I could see that as an exact image. Mm-hmm. So that whole, whatever that that power was expressing that way, Gigi, I want to share. I was like so
excited.
Wow,
great.
Yes, Swami. Even I also put up in my bio memory that being a veterinarian is a big grace for me to communicate with animals and things like that. After yesterday's your rude awakening, Darshan, there was some real change in me with the animals. They are wild animals, I can confirm. And the big ones, we are the few who really went with the big ones. And some of our devotees, Srikant and all, they played with the small ones and went. So I could see in the tiger's eyes the way they could relate, they can show their communication. I can appreciate that the difference. And when we were petting, really cool, that stomach and all, they were really receiving it from us. And the same way when we were on the elephant, I told Nithidevi, Kanna, the pregnant Raja, the Taniya Oda. Then she said, Daddy, I can scan and see that it is inside, baby is there. He confirmed with that. That biomemory changes are really
the
happening.
The powers are real. Yeah. Great. Enjoy.
Thanks,
actually, it'll help you in your profession.
Yes,
a lot.
Definitely.
Backside.
I also went once when we were in the cruise. I went once before entering into the cruise. I don't know which city it is. So I went near the tiger and put my foot, and he licked my foot. And touched my touched with the head my foot, and I blessed him. All right. Anandam aarunga. Which side?
Exit side.
Yes.
Swami, I have two questions. One is about like a clarification. On the day of the I think it was that day, I had a weird vision. Like, we were in the dining hall and suddenly for no reason I started dancing. And everyone around me, like seeing me, they were like mesmerized, literally just staring at me. And there's this one person, he comes, he looks, and then he runs away, and then everything turns black. And the next thing I see is that you are there. And then for a few minutes, like all the tables are flying and everything. And then a few minutes I stop, and you come and touch my head. And then the next thing I remember is that we're in a black area, literally everything's black. And I see you and me, and the thing I hear is that I say pranam to you and you say blessings, and then I ask you where am I, and then we both have a conversation, but I wasn't able to hear it. And then then the last thing I hear is that thou art atma. That's the last thing I hear. And then we wake up, and then we go outside, and you say something to like the crowd, and everyone starts clapping. That's the last thing I remember.
It's a wonderful vision. You had the darshan of the Tarunagiri Yogeshwara's cave.
Data side. It's
I have.
Give me a few minutes. No, yeah, wait. She has not yet finished. You are not yet finished. Go ahead.
And I have another thing. See, like all the kids, they heard from you that based on their gotra, they have like, according to their rishi, they have some knowledge or something. So for all the kids, I want, on behalf of them, I want to ask that all of us should have that knowledge awakened in us.
That is one. For Gurukul kids, my gotra will be awakened. Enjoy.
And I have a question about soulmates. Why is it so intense, and how can you deal with the intense emotions when you meet a soulmate?
Is it No. Please understand, the concept of soulmate is stupid. Just forget it.
Okay.
The concept of soulmate is stupid. Your guru is your soulmate. There is no other soulmate. How can soul have a mate? All other mate are body mate, mind mate. Only guru is your soulmate. No other soulmate. The concept as it is in the West is, forget about it. Dump it.
Okay, thank you. Devotee.
Go ahead. Backside is the word I heard.
Hi Swamiji, I just wanted to thank you also for, this is amazing. I've been going to IA since 2009, and this is by far the most intense IA. It's awesome. The people here are amazing. What we're going through is amazing, and I just wanted to share a couple things with the third eye reading and muscle memory. First off, muscle memory. I had a major pain in my hip to my knee where I literally couldn't stand or sit, and when we went through the muscle memory process with you, I woke up in the morning and it was completely gone. And I mean, it was like something that you would experience, if you had that kind of pain, you'd probably have it for a good week or two. It just was gone the next day. So that was amazing. Then when I was doing third eye readings, what was crazy was I'd have letters in front of me, and I'd hear somebody else say like carrot or cucumber, and then I'd hear C, and I'd say C, and they'd say yes. I was actually hearing the words from other people, which I thought was really strange, but is that?
That is also an experience of third eye.
Okay. I'm also seeing, recently I was seeing landscapes, just images of distant landscapes I've never seen before, mountain ranges or woods. Is that part of
maybe,
third eye?
Maybe those spaces you visited earlier and had experience, higher experience.
Okay. Also, I have a real strong connection with nature and meteor and weather. Rain and clouds and lightning, I go crazy. I got to watch it all the time.
Blessings.
So I just wondered, is that from past life or is that just
No. That is a spiritual quality.
Okay. Also, I've been in IT for 20 years, and I'd like my hair back.
Tatas.
Thank you, Swamiji. So I worked for a large non-for-profit for 3 years, and I really liked it. And I was the senior engineer for connecting Australia and to Japan and all the internet connections. And I made the decision, the conscious decision, to come here. And I don't know if you saw it on Facebook or not, but I was going back and forth through managers and CIOs and HR and back and forth and back and forth. And they just kept saying no, so I resigned to come here. And I just want to know, is that saying kind of like, that's the end of that career path, maybe you should try something new?
Yes.
Okay.
I think you should do something for your own. This whole intelligence, why do you want to be used it by somebody else?
Yeah.
Have self-respect and right inner image. All the fruits of it, you enjoy.
Thank you, Swamiji.
That's it.
Thank you.